GTV. Today I will be showing you how to install auxiliary contacts to ABB's A line of contactors. Auxiliary contacts can either be side or top mounted. The CA5 series here is a top mounted auxiliary contact and is available in single normally open or normally closed configurations, or four pole circuits with a combination of normally open and normally closed circuits. The single pole contacts can also be ganged for additional contacts. To install the single pole auxiliary contacts, such as the CA51, line up the gray plastic tab with one of the openings of the screw terminals on the front face. Then line up the channel of the auxiliary contact with the stops on the front of the contactor. The auxiliary contact should rest flushed against the contactor. Now I can simply slide the contact into place. To remove the auxiliary contact, I will push down the white plastic tab and push up on the auxiliary contact. For the four-pole top-mount auxiliary contact, I can line up the channel of the contact with the four stops on the front face of the contactor. Then I will position the two plastic tabs into the open face of the outer edge screw terminals and slide the auxiliary contact down. I can remove the auxiliary contact by pushing down on the white plastic tab while sliding the contact up. The side mount auxiliary contacts require a visual inspection to find which auxiliary contact is needed. Contactors with a model number up to 75 use the CAL 511, as model numbers 95 and larger use a CAL 1811, CEL 181, or CEL 1810. Some of the larger models might still use the CAL 511 if they were manufactured prior to 2003. A quick way to determine which contactor to use is to look at the indentations on the side of the contactor. The CAL 511 has a locator tab in the middle, as the CAL 1811 has two locator tabs spread further apart from each other. The contactor should have indentations as to where the locator tab can be placed. Comparing an older A210 to an A145, I can see the difference from where each auxiliary contact can be placed based on the indentations. The CAL 511 can be installed three different ways depending on the model number. Models A or AE9 through 26 and models UA16 through 25 do not need this plastic peg in the upper middle part. This part can be removed without the use of any tools. I can install the auxiliary contact by aligning the plastic hooks with the grooves on the side of the contactor. Then I can lift up the auxiliary contact until it snaps into the side of the contactor. For models A and UA30 through 110, models AE and AF45 through 110, and models AF580 through 750, the mounting port is larger and further from the bottom of the contactor. The CAL 511 will only need the top plastic peg instead of the middle piece. Once again, this piece can also be removed like the top plastic peg was with the other models. Now I can install the auxiliary contact by aligning the plastic hooks with the grooves on the side of the contactor. Then I can lift up the auxiliary contact until it snaps into the side of the contactor. Models A and AF145 to 300 and AF400 to 460 have a larger mounting port, but are not as far from the bottom as the previous model. To install the auxiliary contact, I will need to remove both plastic pegs. Then I will take the peg that was in the upper spot and insert it into the middle part of the contact. I can then line up the grooves on the side of the contactor and snap on the auxiliary contact. ABB's auxiliary contacts, along with thousands of other products and services, are available at galco.com.